Hello friends, welcome to the video. In this quick video, you will have a look at the IELTS writing task advantages and disadvantages template. So in this quick video, I'll tell you how you people can make use of the template which I'm going to share with you and write on advantages and disadvantages essay by using this template. You can memorize the sentences which I'm going to provide, so that will be quick for you to write your essay under the given time limit. Okay, so here on the screen you can see I have prepared, like I have put the paragraphs which you are going to cover in the advantages and disadvantages essay. But before that, let's have a look at a question, a sample question from IELTS exam. So the question is here on the screen. It says, a lot of places in the world rely on tourism as a main source of income. Unfortunately, tourism can also be a source of problems if it is not managed correctly. Describe the advantages and disadvantages of tourism in the modern world. Do you think that benefits of tourism outweigh its drawbacks? So the question is pretty simple. Here we need to talk about whether tourism brings positive things or it's a negative trend. Now let's have a quick look at the paragraphs which I charted out here for you. So paragraph 1 will be about the introduction. Simple. We are going to write a normal introduction the way we used to write for the essays. Just a quick thing about the introduction. You can write a 3-sentence introduction with the tip which I am going to share with you. First of all, in the sentence 1, you just write a general statement about the topic sentence. A general statement about the topic statement, or you can say people also call it paraphrase or rephrase, whatever you want to call it. Sentence 1. In sentence 2, you can write what do you think about the given problem, about the given statement. Say if you think positives, tourism brings positive thing or it's a beneficial for the country or for the society, then you can write your opinion. Yes, I do think so. Okay. And in the third sentence, you can tell the reader about your plan. By writing, see, you can write in this essay, in the following essay, I'm going to discuss some of the advantages or some of the drawbacks of the tourism. So this way you can write a three sentence introduction for your any essay. Okay, now let's move forward. Now we have paragraph 2. So in the paragraph 2, okay, before that, before you go in deep and start writing, before that, you brainstorm some ideas. You think of some of the advantages of the tourism and some of the disadvantages. So at least you pick 2 advantages which you think you can justify those advantages easily. You pick those 2 advantages. Say, for example, for the tourism, here the topic is tourism, right? So the first advantage is like it brings money to the country, right? It brings money to the country. And second advantage is it promotes the tourists, right? They promote our country, our culture worldwide in their country. Okay. So here we have 2 advantages. So we'll talk about advantage 1. So I'm not saying, so we are not going to write just the advantages. We'll explain. I'll tell you how to write this paragraph 2 and paragraph 3. I think let me tell you here only. So what you can do is here in, no, I think I have the template ready. So I'll discuss how to write paragraph 2 and paragraph 3 later in this video. So stay tuned with me. Now you have already put 2 advantages, right? Now let's talk. Think about 2 disadvantages of the tourism. You can think of many, but pick the 2 which you can explain easily and in a better manner. So 2 disadvantages. Disadvantage first. So here you can write disadvantage first is like you can write, the first drawback of tourism is that the maintenance, like loss to the property. See, when the number of people are increasing, right, at a site where visitors are increasing, so it's become very, very hard to manage the things, and sometimes they harm the properties, right? Or they put the garbage or whatever they throw or whatever you can call it, right? So sometimes it harm the property. And another disadvantage is like sometimes there are tourists from different countries They bring illegal things. They just shows that they are here in the country for the tourism, but basically they are bringing illegal items or illegal stuff, or could be drugs or sometimes some sort of illnesses which can cause a trouble to the entire country. So these are the two drawbacks of the tourism. And then in the paragraph 6, you are just going to write the conclusion. How will you write the conclusion? It's very simple. What you have to do is, first of all, you discuss whatever you have, the positives, whatever the advantages which you have mentioned here in the paragraph 2 and 3. Summarize those two advantages in your words, and then in paragraph 4 and two disadvantages which you have mentioned here, paragraph 4 and 5, in your own words. Like, summarize those points, 4 points here and here, and write your opinion. You say, yeah, we do have some drawbacks because of tourism, but tourism brings more money, so which is like basically strength world's economy, or sorry, country's economy. Correct. So this way you can write your essay. Now let's have a quick look at the template. So in the template, we just need to fill the template. The template is ready to use. You just need to fill the template by using your own words. Okay, so let's have a look first the introduction part. Okay, so here you can see the introduction. It says, nowadays you start, because you're talking about a common topic. So it says nowadays, and then you write a general statement about the topic. You write nowadays, and then you write a general statement. So here, for example, I'm not going to discuss a full solution, but here I can give you some tips so that you can make use of those tips to complete your essay. So nowadays, more people, right? Or you can say nowadays, tourism, or people are more into traveling worldwide this way, right? And then, for example, then you write an extra sentence to support the first sentence. For example, then you can write, there are people who earn money, and then later by end of the year, the move to some foreign country to visit, to fulfill their dreams, right? Then, however, so you can memorize this. Nowadays, you can memorize. You can make use of this whenever you have advantages and disadvantages essay. You can make use of this keyword nowadays. Then write a general statement about the topic, and then you write, for many people, write one supporting argument, one more sentence to support the first one. Okay, and then you have, however, there are both pros and cons, because we are talking about the advantages and disadvantages. So you will write, there are both pros and cons of deciding to do this. Herein, I'll discuss. So this is sentence one, a normal sentence. Here, you're going to talk about, there are both pros and cons of tourism. So here I'll discuss some of the reasons why tourism is beneficial, or why it brings good things, and some of the challenges to be overcome, and what are the problems with the tourism, or due to tourism. Okay, so now here we are done with the three sentence introduction. You just need to replace the words, the sentences which are highlighted in red color. You just need to put your own sentence and just make sure the grammar is correct. Okay? Your sentence grammatically should be correct. Now let's move forward. Now here we have, here we have paragraph 2. So in this paragraph 2, I'm going to talk about first advantages of the tourism. So you can write, let's begin by looking at the advantages of tourism. Simple. Or you write one topic sentence in your words. So let's begin by looking at the advantages of your sentence. One of the main positives. What is the first advantages? Like, it brings money. It brings money to the country. Then you can explain what I mean by this. So here you can write that whenever tourists come, right, they spend money on the stay, on the while they use the public sources, vehicles. You can say while they travel, and you can also write when they buy food. So there are different items, right? So they basically they are spending money. So basically they are the money is coming to us, right? So they basically they bring money. Then you can explain here how. For example, here you can give the examples, like for the traveling, for the food, and sometimes they buy stuff, right? So this way basically they are bringing money to the country. And then you can conclude, this strength the country's economy basically, right? Or provide more jobs. More jobs, how you can say, like sometimes tourists, right, they hire a guide, okay, or sometimes they buy stuff. So you can have shops around the places where people visit, so that you can buy some souvenirs, you can sell some souvenir or some other items which you want to sell, or water bottles or food, whatever. Now let's talk about the paragraph 3. So in paragraph 3, we are going to talk about the another advantage. So write what your good example is here. Some write here second advantage, and then briefly explain, give an example, or in addition you will conclude it. So you can say another advantage which I would say is tourism, what they do for us. Okay, so better in the first paragraph, we just talk about the money, like that brings money, the strength or give power to the our economy, right? And in second advantage, you can talk about the bring job opportunities, because like whenever we have, say, there is a new site, a location one or a site where people visit. So there would be people to maintain the particular thing. And there will be people to provide services like transport services, food services, some other shop, right? So this way, that brings job opportunities as well. So you can mention those things here in the second advantage. Now let's talk about the disadvantage. What are the disadvantages with the tourism? Okay, so here we'll talk about the first disadvantage. So turning to the other side of the argument. So this is how, what you can memorize this one. Turning to the other side of the argument. This is like, now you are going to talk about the other side. Other side means the negative impacts. Okay, so turning to the other side of the argument, and then you write first disadvantage. What is like, you first, so you have some ideas, right? You have some disadvantages. So write your first disadvantage here. Basically, like it damage to the property, you can say. Then to be more precise, now here you will write some explanation. Why do you think there will be more tourists than there will be damage to the property? You have to explain here in the second sentence. And then let's give some example. Like, for example, there is a crack in the wall, or something has been damaged. So you can give an example from your own experience. You might have visited to some places and then you have seen, yeah, there are some issues, right, with the location. So here you can talk about the damage to the property. Now let's look at the another disadvantage, second disadvantage. Here another issue is that it means I am going to talk about the another problem or another negative impact. Another issue is that, you can use this one as it is. Another issue is that, write the second disadvantage here. Now you put your second disadvantage. Another issue is that, second disadvantage, they bring, or you can say they promote illegal activities in the country. For example, Goa, which is very famous for the illegal, for the drugs and for the stuff. Another issue is that, write second disadvantage here. You will put your second disadvantage here. What do you think? Say they bring, the promote illegal activities. In other words, now here you explain that there are people who comes from different countries that bring illegal items, say for example drugs or you can say illegal money, or you can say illegal weapons, right? Or the another disadvantage here is like, when we have, like, if there is a popular site, say for example Taj Mahal, that is one of the most popular, we can say, a tourist attraction, right? But pickpocketing, stealing goods is very common, right? So again, these things promote those bad things as well. So this process takes time and especially can be challenging if, so here you will conclude your disadvantage here. Okay, now how are you going to write the conclusion? Conclusion is going to be the very important part. So I'll tell you how to write the conclusion. Okay. So here in the conclusion, what you have to do is, so you can start, there are multiple ways to start a conclusion. You can use one given is here, all things considered. Okay. Or what you can do is just to summarize, to sum up, you can use these phrases as well, right? So here, for example, I have used all things considered. Then you will write a general one sentence summary of the topic. One sentence summary of the topic, like here I'm talking about the tourism. So all things considered, and then you will write a one sentence summary of the topic. Now you need to weigh up the pros of. Now you will describe, you will summarize the your positive things which you have mentioned in paragraph 2 and paragraph 3. And then you will write and cons of. Here you will write. So you need to weigh up the pros of to the advantages, the cons of to disadvantages, basically here disadvantages. Okay. And then personally, I believe in terms of here, now you will write your advantage. You think, yeah, tourism is good for the country, eventually outweighs the negatives. Okay. So now here we are done. So what you have to do is, I'll show you the complete essay. You can pause this video here and then you can note this down so that you can make use of this one to write a better essay. The thing which you need to keep in mind is that when you do so, right, you just careful, like you just need to replace, or you just need to put your stuff in the highlighted red boxes, red sentences, just replace those red sentences and make sure whatever sentence you put, right, those sentences grammatically should be correct. Those sentences grammatically correct. Okay. So guys, stay tuned for more. Thank you.